Hey guys, what's up? My name is Ben. Today, David and I are building this my new computer. There's all the parts, the cases over there somewhere. So today's video is just going to be sort of a build montage sort of thing. I'll probably have benchmarks later on, but right now I'm just going to show off all the parts and then we're going to build it. So I've got a GTX 1070 for the win edition, a 700 watt power supply also from EVGA, a DVD player or a DVD reader, writer, whatever, because I have some games on DVD that I don't want to lose, 2 terabyte hard drive from Seagate, 16 gigs of RipJaws 5 RAM from G-Skill, a couple of fan splitters because I didn't know which ones I needed to get, 120 gig SSD from SanDisk, a Hyper 212 Evo from Cooler Master for the CPU, and an i5 6600K from Intel, extra case fan from Cooler Master, and the ASRock Super Alloy H110M ITX / AC, so it's got Wi-Fi included, which is going to be important because I don't have a way to get wired internet all the way out here. And the case is the Fractal Design Define R4. So I'm going to go ahead and take that out, and we'll be back once I've got everything on the table that needs to be on the table. Okay, so we are back. And we are with the motherboard, the H110M, blah, 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 all those other things. So I'm going to go ahead and unwrap it. I'm going to go ahead and take it out, David. So first things first, we need to go ahead and put the CPU and the RAM in before we actually stick the board in the case. Go ahead and grab the box real quick. We're going to set this on top of there. Okay. So, first, we're putting in the CPU, so we need to unlatch this thing. I think we just push it down and slide it over. There we go. Alright. And so, okay. Now, what you don't want to touch the bottom or the top of this. You're just going to touch the sides because you don't want to get any oils or anything on the bottom or the top, because the top is where the thermal paste is going to go. So you need to line up this, I don't know if I can get it, this triangle right here on the edge of the CPU, if I can get it to focus, right there. There's going to be another triangle on the motherboard somewhere right there. Should be about the same, well, not the same size or the same color, but it's a triangle. And that'll tell you which way to put the CPU in. So you just kind of drop it in. And I can actually get it in there. Come on, come on. I don't want to bend any of the pins. There we go. Jiggle it around a little bit just to make sure, even though I just touched the top. Oh well. And then we're going to put this back down, slide it back into there, and then you push it back down and slip it back under. Don't worry about it. That black top is supposed to come off.
Oh, scared the crap out of me. I heard something snapping. And
there we go. All right. So now our processor is securely in. We can just set that black thing aside, and then we're going to put the RAM in. So, DDR4, actually any RAM, should have a slot somewhere in the middle, and you're going to match that up with the slot in the RAM.
Does this not have tabs that open out?
It's probably just on one side.
Oh, okay.
So what you're going to do, you're going to open up the tabs. You're going to make sure that the tab on the RAM lines up with the tab on the motherboard, and it looks like it is.
Yeah.
So you just gotta press down evenly on it until it, come on, snaps in. There we go.
Should be securely in there now.
Dave was going to do the next one. Don't worry about doing anything on the motherboard. Just press it down until it snaps.
Thick. There we go.
It looks like it's good.
It's about the same. I think we're good.
There we go. There we go.
Let me make sure. You got that one?
Yep.
It looks good.
I heard it snap into place.
Okay, so now our motherboard is taken care of. We're going to go ahead and set the case on the table, and then we will be back. Okay, so we're going to put in the motherboard backplate now. Hopefully you can kind of see that. You're going to have to press hard because it does not go in very easily. Sorry if I sound super professional. I'm just kind of... I've never built one before either, but I'm kind of regurgitating exactly what I've heard through Linus Tech Tips and other videos that I've watched of people building computers.
Should just snap into place, right?
Just have to be a little bit forceful. Oh, come on.
This is very, very hard, and I'm probably blocking. There we go.
I think it's in. It should be in. Oh, nope, that bottom part isn't in yet.
I think we're good now. Well-ish. Alright, well, we'll just leave it there. It should be okay. Now we're going to go ahead and install the standoffs for the motherboard. We're going to go ahead and put the motherboard down just to kind of line up where the holes are going to go. So it goes in just like this. So we need, I think we only need these few holes at the top here. There's one, two, three, four, maybe a couple more, depending. So we're just gonna take that back out. So, one, two, that does not have a hole there. So just one, two, three, four. So, there's your two. I'll put the two in up top.
So you screw it in.
Yes.
Bottom side, right?
Yep. So we have screws for the motherboard.
Now. So very, very tiny.
Very, very tiny, and I don't want to cross-thread it.
Trusty robo grips. Hopefully this will help a little bit. I don't think that I've put it in quite right.
What makes you say that?
Just doesn't feel like it.
There we go. Okay. So now, very carefully. And all the way you need.
I guess they're just meant to be very difficult to screw into place.
Well, if it's very difficult to screw in, then it's going to be very difficult to get out.
I don't know. I mean, they feel okay, but they are awfully...
Ooh, I just scratched it a little bit. Oh, well.
They are awfully tight. I don't know. That's just the way it's supposed to be. screens on the bottom and everything.
Dust filter.
Mm-hmm. Probably not a bad thing.
No, never a bad thing. Never, ever, ever. Never have I ever.
Okay. That one, I'm gonna have to be a little careful with that one.
If you want, we could probably take that out of the way if you wanted.
That's good. I think that one's okay. Okay, and then the last one. Good thing is about this, this has got some really good cable management features on here that I never knew, I never saw coming. Come on.
They're not all over the place. They've tucked them in pretty good.
Okay. We should be okay now. All right, so now we're going to drop the motherboard into place. Very, very, very carefully. So we just need to line up all of the holes. Ooh. I can line them up. What is this thing here? Maybe I need to slide that under here. So I think...
Hold on.
Ooh. Well, I gotta do that over again. We're having some technical difficulties. We'll be back in a second.
We are experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand by.
Okay, so take two of putting in the motherboard.
After we got the back plate incorrectly this time.
Yeah. Turns out that it's a lot easier to put in there once you actually, once you turn it on its back.
Probably should have done that first.
Yeah.
But.
Come on.
That's what learning.
What is this thing? I don't understand what this is.
What is that lined up with?
It's still lined up with the HDMI
board. Yeah, that is. Okay, so.
Where is the motherboard book? Here we go.
Is it supposed to support the top, or is it supposed to?
Not worried about the headers and connectors yet. Oh, apparently this is so big because most of it is not in English.
Yeah.
Okay. So are we supposed to do anything with the back panel once we get it on?
I don't think so. I think we're just...
Huh. Yeah. I don't know. Well, I'm gonna have to try to figure this out. Oh, I see the Wi-Fi thing. Okay. The wireless AC. Gotta stick the, where do those go? I know there's Wi-Fi antennas in here. Just don't know where they go.
analyst is supposed to go up top.
I think.
I don't think it wants to go in.
Oh, there we go.
There you go. Oh. I see.
Okay, so I think that we've got everything. Let's just get those lined up. Okay.
I see.
So now, I think, which ones are the motherboard screws? I think these are it.
Did it say?
No, it doesn't.
They don't label it? Do they label the bag at all? Like with shapes?
To secure HDD trays.
Nope.
I'm going to say that this is it. How many screws are in here? There's 8. We have 9 standoffs. So I think this is it. We're probably just an extra standoff in there. We only need 4. Okay, so David can go ahead and do the first one. Or the first couple, rather.
What size is that? The tiny little thing.
Tiny, 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 tiny.
Probably the smallest. That'll work perfectly. Probably the smallest bit there is.
Okay, so all of them are lined up. Just try not to jostle it too much. It's magnetic, so you can just leave the screw on the screwdriver when you put it in.
I might do that.
Kind of why I wanted that one, okay. So it's not as hard. It's harder to lose the screws.
Being very careful not to tighten them down too much, because I definitely do not want any stress cracks.
Yeah, that would not be good.
Get my hand out of the shot.
There we go.
I'm just gonna put them in.
That should be fine. The back plate should hold everything in. And I mean,
we'll go in and tighten them down some later, but right now yeah. I just want.
All right, so now, my turn. Let's go ahead and put this in.
We're probably going to be changing these a lot, so I'm going to try to put this in a safe spot.
Okay.
So I don't lose it. But so that's accessible. I like that they're using Phillips. You don't have to have some special...
For real.
Some special Torx bit or something.
Okay, so I think what we're going to do next is we are going to put in the graphics card. So, give us a moment while we go ahead and set up that shot, because there's a lot of crap on the table, and we will be back in just a second. All right, so David is opening up the 1070. Take off all the plastic that they decided to put all over it.
You know you're proud of your product when you have good packaging options.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think it just opens. Oh, there's tape on the side.
Yeah, of course.
Here.
Oh, did you bring a knife?
Yeah, I brought a knife.
Okay.
Just be careful. Don't hurt yourself.
Don't worry. For many years I've done stuff with knives. I have not managed to cut myself.
Yeah.
I did tell you I was trying to sell knives, right?
Oh, were you?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
So.
Okay, so I think you just open up the side.
I think so too. But it's such a pretty box. I don't want to.
I think I've seen the inside of the box on the video, so I think the inside is even nicer looking.
Yeah, I think obviously got to slide out. It's probably just packaged so tight that it doesn't...
There we go, okay.
It doesn't want to slide.
So now here we have the 1070's box. That looks dope. Look at this.
A box within a box. I like this. Within a box.
Okay. So now...
See how pretty this is. Can you guys see this?
Yep, they're good. Okay.
I want to see what this looks like.
So we've got all of this. I guess this is documentation.
Some of it.
I don't know what that is.
With a badge and the CD.
Well, we're not going to install any of those drivers from the CD, not even from the motherboard. We're just going to download it all from their website. So that'll give us all the latest drivers without having to worry about anything. Whoopsies! Okay.
It's so pretty.
Is the 1070. We're going to very, very, very carefully...
Assuming nothing's left in the box. I'll come back.
Okay. And here it is. Got the bag on it. Ooh, look at that.
Oof!
We're going to take off the film real quick. Oops.
It's just a box.
Oh, well.
The box that I took so much care not to break, I just let it fall on the floor.
Get the film off.
It's on the edge.
Here we go. Okay. Now that we got that figured out, maybe.
Hopefully.
Whoop.
Got it?
Yep. I've got it. Thankfully, they put this protective cover on the bottom side of the power connector, the motherboard connector. You love the smell of plastic in the morning.
Yep.
Oh, there's some nasty, sticky plastic. Come on.
Graphics card's twice as big as the motherboard. I'm beginning to see the mad genius behind this.
Okay, so this is the 1070 for the Win Edition. It's got a couple of 8-pin power connectors up top, some gigantic fans, and it is factory overclocked. I think it's just 100 megahertz, but I'm probably going to overclock it some more manually. We'll see. If it gives me good performance off the bat, then we're just going to keep it as is for now. Okay, so now we need to get into the case again. We're going to take off the top two screws right here. Let me see. I think it's those two. We stick this in here.
Yeah, looks like just two.
Yeah. Yep, okay. Set that down carefully. Oof. Okay. Well, I think we're going to need the screwdriver for that. They're supposed to be thumb screws, but hardly anybody ever.
Might need
it
a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, try that.
Hardly anybody ever just screws them in. You just do it by machine, so... Except for the side panel ones, we were able to get those off no problem.
Yeah.
So...
They're probably more concerned with something like that coming loose and scratching the inside. So they're like, we're going to tighten this baby down some. Which, I mean, I don't blame them.
No. Okay, so we're going to need to keep track of those two thumb screws. But the back plates we don't really need to worry about because the graphics card is going to be slotted into there. We're going to take this little protective cover thingy off. I'm going to zoom back out. Take this little protective cover thingy off. And then we're going to slot it very carefully right into the slot on the motherboard. Go. Okay, so now we need to get those two thumb screws back on. Set the plastics off. We should just be able to tighten them up by hand if we can actually.
You know what? The screwdriver might be easier because of that.
Where does it go? I think it goes. Does it go right there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to hold this. You go ahead and. Don't usually need to worry about forcing some of the components into place, like the graphics card, because if you don't, if you just leave it as is...
It's not lined up.
Yeah.
100%.
If you just leave it as is, it could sag when you set the system up, and that's not... It's not necessarily a bad thing, but just aesthetically, it's not great, and sometimes it's not really that great for the computer either. So... That's right there. I got it.
There we go. I think.
Yeah, that looks good. Just be very careful. Stick the next one in. I'll keep holding this. Although, no, I don't need to. Okay.
Once you get one, you pretty much...
Oh, I think we're running out of space on my card.
We are experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand by.
Okay, so we're back. You may notice that we put the CPU cooler on there because we got everything in there without... Without doing that...
There was a panel on the back, so we thought we had it.
Yeah.
But it wasn't big enough.
Yep.
So
that's okay. We just took everything apart, we put it all back in, and now we're back here. So I'm going to go ahead and install the 2 terabyte hard drive into this thing. I think this is actually... That must be... That's probably too small. Yeah, so I need... Probably these bottom drive bays. One of the bottom drive bays.
You want the top one?
That works. These are tinier. What?
Uh-oh.
I guess it really doesn't matter.
It worked. Whatever you want to put it, I guess. Are they the same size?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
These don't have screws from the... I see. We're going to screw them in from the bottom. Got the little grommets there.
Mm-hmm.
So... See, there's one there, one there. So we just need to move both of these up one. Oh, so I probably did that off camera. Wow, that's really smart of me. Okay. So, let me make sure that this is all lined up here for you guys. And then... Okay. So, we need to get this lined up here. That should be good. We need hard drive screws. Which are... Somewhere here, one of these set of hard drive screws, that's grommets. Thought they did anyway. Those thumb screws, those probably aren't it. This might be it. Oh, these. I think, oh yeah, these are it. Okay, so here we've got the hard drive screws. We only need four of them. David's just kind of cleaning up all the mess I'm leaving behind.
It'll help us keep organized.
Yeah.
And we don't need it all right now anyway, but we're
okay.
Done with the cooler, we're done with the CPU box, we're done with the video card box, I think.
Yep. There shouldn't be anything else that we need in here. Although I'm interested to see. Oh. They're 8-pin power cords? Probably for a modular power supply.
What is that power supply mounting on this?
6-pin to 8-pin. It's going to be on the bottom. That's why there's a filter right there.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Okay.
That makes
sense. So, yeah. We've got 2 6-pin to 1 8-pin connector adapters for the graphics card, just in case our power supply doesn't work.
Where do you want your extra backing plates? Just
throw them in the case box over there. Okay, so these should be okay.
You don't want to keep any of this plastic crap, do you?
No, don't need it.
The shells.
You know what? I might be putting this on backwards. Do I want to put it on? No. Okay, let's flip this around a little bit, now that I kind of know what I'm doing. Barely.
What is this? This is for the motherboard. Which is right here.
Whoop!
Did you lose something?
Yep, just lost the screw.
Do you want any of these cables
in here? We do need some of those. A couple of them are the SATA data cables, which we're going to need to hook up the hard drive and the SSD.
Alright, I'll leave this box next to us.
And then there's also the 2 Wi-Fi antennas in there.
What are those hooked up at?
They hook up in the back somewhere.
They're not buried somewhere, are they?
No.
I hope not. I don't want to take it out again.
I don't blame you.
Garbage, more screws galore, guys. They're everywhere. Some fancy thing, I don't know what it's for.
Some fancy thing?
Oh, I know what that is. That's, I guess, to put the stops in easier.
Oh, yeah.
An adapter.
Yeah. Oh.
That may have helped us.
Yeah.
Instead of
using the robo grips. I didn't even realize that. There we go. Okay. Hard drive is in. Not that you can see it because I'm an idiot. But I just snapped that right into place. It just here. And just pop it out and just pop it right back in. Just like that. We've also got the. Woo! I'm moving the camera. I've also got the 128 SSD, which is going to be my C drive, the drive that Microsoft installs all of their
Why do they call it a C drive? Is that just what they designated it, and that's just what people call it?
Yep, I guess so. I'm going to make the hard disk my Z drive, because I can.
Just because you can?
Yep. Woo!
Oh, that's the case.
I don't need any of that.
More cables. I'm gonna put all the cables in one spot.
Oh, is this under that?
And all the screws in another spot. You don't want the box, so that's crap.
Yeah, just put that in the case.
In the case box?
Yep. Okay, so here we've got the SSD. My framing is probably all off here, but I'm not a professional tech tuber or anything. I just kind of wanted to show you guys what I'm going to be working with now because, you know, I mean, I'm going to be using this for the channel. So, yeah. Actually, you know what? I'm going to move this.
GTX 900 series.
What? The GTX 900 series?
No, that's what that's
like. 10. Oh, 10900.
Oh, never mind. I didn't see the 10. So that's the graphics card with that.
Yep.
Oh, on the floor where I last left it. Because I didn't care if it went crashing down or not.
How in the world do I install this? Oh, this might not go here. Where does this go?
Do they have a provision for an SSD in this?
Yeah, they should. SSDs are a pretty common place now.
Well, I would imagine so.
I'm going to see if maybe there's... Ooh, what in the world was that? Maybe there's
cables
on the back for it. I think there might be. There's mounting somewhere for it. Okay, we're going to hold off on this while I find out where to mount the SSD. You're just looking at the front of the case now. But, so yeah, we'll be back. Okay, so we figured it out where the SSD goes. There's four screws right here. The manual for this case did not say that at all. It said it wanted me to install it on the back plate for the motherboard, and I was not about that life. So I just looked up a YouTube video and it told me different. So all we need to do again is line up the screws on the SSD, the four holes on here, and we screw the holes in.
You got it facing the right way? Your plugs?
Nope.
Your ports?
Nope. Of course not. I'm too smart for that, David.
That's why I'm here. I'm trying to help think of things.
Okay. So... this should be the right screw. We can get it in there. There we go. We just kind of got to get it in there.
You didn't have rubber grommets for those.
Yeah, that's fine.
But it is plastic. It's not like it vibrates or anything.
Yeah, exactly.
I guess that's probably why. It's not like it's got moving parts.
Okay, this is not going in right. Now you going in right? There we go, that's much easier. Okay.
So pretty.
Okay. Maybe one day we'll be able to put a computer together without having to take it apart three or four times.
Yeah, that's okay.
Or look up YouTube videos. Well, we'll still probably have to do that, let's be real.
But hey, that's what the internet's for, guys.
Yep.
This is exactly what this is for. You can learn from our mistakes.
Please do. Don't take the extra 20, 30 minutes because you forgot to put your CPU cooler on, so you have to literally take everything apart again.
Yep.
But that's okay. It's trial and error. It's our first time building a PC. And hopefully whenever we get David's together, sometime next year, it'll go a lot smoother.
It should. I'm not doing as complicated as a build either.
No.
Well, at least not as of yet.
Yeah. Okay. So now, we're just going to... good lord. I'm just going to slide this thing in. Like so. Right up at the top slot right there. Stick it in. That's what she said.
Oh, jeez.
It's a lot harder than it should be. That's also what she said. Come on. There we go.
Boop. Success.
That's what she said. Okay, so now we're putting in the CD drive, which I almost forgot, or DVD drive, rather. We took this piece off right here and just opened up the front door. It's easy as pie.
Wonderful.
I think it's just magnetic.
Wonderful.
So, I took that off. This slot is open now, so we're just going to slide it into here, which should be... There's something right there. Let me get this wire out of the way. Something is fighting me.
Does it go in from the back?
I don't... Well, maybe. Here, see if you can put it in that way.
Wow. I'll stick it in. This cord is like, I don't know what this is.
Is it mounted?
I might not be able to use the CD drive quite yet because I forgot that that needs a SATA power too, or a SATA data, and I didn't get one of those. Oh well. That's okay. So I won't be editing this quite yet, but at least I'll get to enjoy it. In the meantime. While,
Is it mounted or is it not?
It shouldn't be. I don't think so.
So you want to just take it out?
I'm going to just try putting it in the slot below that.
What does it say to data, anyways?
It's, runs from the power cable, or not, from the motherboard to like a hard drive or CD, DVD drive.
Mm-hmm.
It's that right there.
Oh.
But that's okay. I can go ahead and get the thing installed. That is weird, this part. I guess I just needed to take that front panel part off. And then maybe we put this back in.
Oh, there's your faceplate up there besides.
Yeah.
Mm.
So now is it gonna move? Oh, it does move a little bit. There must be mounting screws or something for it.
Yeah, right there, on the side.
Yeah. Okay.
That'll keep it from moving.
So I think, is it these? I don't know which one is which, TBH.
Right now, it's not all that important.
Yeah. It's not those. It's not those. Got like 6,000 different screws here. I don't need screws to secure the HDD trays. These are extra thumb screws. Maybe the extra thumb screws will work there. Side. This must be like super duper boring to watch.
Are you talking about these? Is that the same data?
No. I think these are all front panel connectors.
No. Never mind.
There we go. It is the thumb screws. It's good to know. Whatever works.
Oh wow, tiny little thing. Whatever makes it easier, right?
Yeah.
Come on.
That does not want to screw. Oh, there we go. Oh. Yeah, I probably don't want to screw it in that way.
What you do?
Screw it in sideways.
Yay, I win.
Yeah, what? Two of them are connected.
That's good enough.
Not going to move anywhere.
No.
Okay. So now, I think the last part is the power supply. And then after that, we get all the power and stuff hooked up. So we'll get back to you when we get the power supply put in. Okay, so about now we're trying to stick the power supply in. Realized that the extra case fan that I got was broken, which isn't, you know, the greatest thing, but it's okay. I'll be fine with two case fans for now. I'll just send that one back and reorder it, as well as a SATA cable, SATA data. I don't know, whatever.
Whatever you want to call it.
Some screws, probably.
What's that? Oh, I think they're... One of them is...
Oh, maybe I need longer screws than that, then. Is that as far as it'll go?
Mm-hmm. That's it. That's as far as it goes back.
Yeah, these do work, okay. Sorry, y'all can't really see it all that well. We're just screwing stuff into the back. It's not really all that interesting. But what we're going to have to do after David gets this last one in is we are going to reroute all of the power into the back. I think... Oh, good. We do have two 8-pin powers for our graphics card. 10 out of 10. Okay. So now we take all of these... sort of ketchup mustard looking cables and we are going to, after they decide not to stick into the actual case itself, we might need to route them one by one, but we're just going to stick them all back through this bottom slot back here.
Got it.
Ish. That way. Whoa. Well, alright.
Hopefully it pushes back through.
Yeah, it should. Oop, hold on. There we go.
We'll untangle it on the other side.
Is that everything? Oh, that's about everything.
That's it. That's the last one. Okay. There we go.
So now we've got everything through. Kind of maneuver this little thing around everything. Like it should have been in the first place, but it just decided to pop off. Like the piece of crap that it is.
Oh well.
These are a lot more flexible when I'm doing this. I'm stretching it way, way, way out of proportion here. But that's okay. That's what it deserves for failing me the first time. Oops, what in the world? Oh, just keep going on this. There we go. And we'll keep going on this. Here we go. And that should be all the cables. Well, not really. What in the world happened here? Okay. And this last one. Right. Be nice to me, please. There we go. I think that's all on.
I think we got it. Yeah, we got it.
All right, so now that all the power is routed through, we kind of just need to figure out where everything goes. So, excuse us while we do that, and we'll be back. Okay, so it took some doing, but we finally got everything up and running. We couldn't figure out why it wasn't posting, and apparently we forgot to plug in a power cable to the motherboard, so we fixed that. Everything's doing fine. We're installing Windows now. Already put in my product key. So we're just waiting on that. And yeah, I think that's where I'm going to end this video right now. I do have a couple things that I wish would have worked. The DVI cable that they sent me for my second monitor. Oh. David, was that cable in with the monitor? The one that you pulled out, that what we tried to use before?
Yeah.
I don't need to get another cable. Thank God. I got a cable.
You already did?
Yeah.
Well, then you must have knew that. You must have known that.
Yeah, I knew it wasn't going to take VGA. I guess that's what that is.
It is.
But yeah, so...
That's why I was asking, is this HD? Is
well,
this
going to be I HD? Thought you, because... I thought you took it out of there. I was like, yeah, it's going to be HD. I know it is.
I recognized it. I was like, this has been around for ages. It's not HD, Ben!
What are you talking about? Is 480p not HD, David?
Oh, is that what that's for?
I don't know. Probably like 260p or something like that.
I don't know.
But yeah, so we got everything done. We're going to let Windows install now, I guess. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Shut up. Yo, what's up? I just got this nice new...